22-23. It was Fiona who encouraged me to become a town councillor, and I feel almost it's ironic that I'm now nominating her as mayor, especially with these two women sat next to me as well as former mayors. Fiona's passion for all things political, her keen sense of fairness, forensic attention to detail, and her caring nature make her an ideal candidate as for mayor. Fiona's interest in politics started in Macclesfield County High School for Girls, where she participated in the infamous project, The History Behind the News, and I'm sure Beryl Fulton can tell you a tale or two about that for her enthusiasm. Fiona joined the union on her first day at work, a bit like myself, for a high street bank in Macclesfield. She quickly became an active union representative, and eventually the honorary president of the union and the youngest and only second woman to be elected to this role. So she's always been a trailblazer. Fiona then went on to work for Usdaw, and after 19 years in the legal and human resources departments, she was appointed as the head of research and economics, hence her attention to detail. She represented Usdaw members at the Labour Party National Policy Forum and manifesto negotiations dealing with many important things such as low pay and campaigning for better issues for their members. With all this experience, it's been invaluable to the Town Council. Following retirement in 2018, Fiona now works for two local charitable trusts to manage almshouses, accommodation for elderly people in Macclesfield. Representing South Ward she was elected in 2019 in May. She works tirelessly for her residents. They knock on the door at midnight, and her husband, Brian, will tell you that, to sort things out. She's even made an appearance on television locally, and some residents recorded it for her as well. Hope the water thing gets sorted out. She sits on all the council committees, and she regularly represents Macclesfield Town Council's views at Cheshire's planning and various other meetings. And I'm quite sure with her tenacity, she is being known to be like a dog with a bone, we'll get the Middlewood Way lit and the gritting situation sorted combined with the rest of us. As an active member of the working the Macclesfield Town Centre Recovery Working Group and chair the subgroup on outdoor hospitality, she's helped bring a cosmopolitan feel to the town with a variety of outdoor seating areas and deck chairs as well. It's a pity she can't do anything about the weather. As an avid runner, she's supported lots of young people take part in Macclesfield Run Fest. She regularly volunteers at the park run, and that makes her a natural outdoor and leisure champion for the council. She's also a season ticket holder for Macclesfield Football Club and has been known to sing Sweet Caroline in the post-match celebration, but again, that's another story. So with all this 40 years plus experience, enthusiasm, working and campaigning for the benefit of others, I have no doubt that Fiona will make a fantastic mayor of Macclesfield, supported by her lovely husband Brian as a consort and her wonderful parents who are here tonight. Thank you.
So do I have a seconder, please? Thank you, Councillor Warren. Do you wish to speak?
I don't think Mr. Mayor that I need to say anything more. Sarah's covered every comment. I just think Sarah's a very enthusiastic councillor, and I think very competent as well. I think she'll bring a lot to the role in the mayor. I just hope she's able to have enough time in the day to do the mayoral stuff and the other council stuff that she so eagerly throws herself into. So I've no problem seconding that. So.
Thank you very much. Can I take it straight to the vote then, please? Those in favour of Councillor Wilson being the new mayor? I think that's unanimous, isn't it? Yeah, thank you very much. We now move on to item two, I think, the election of the deputy mayor of Macclesfield. Do I have a proposer for deputy mayor, please? Oh, there you go.
Yeah, I will do. Just very briefly again, I've been impressed with Chris since he's been on the council. I know he's very active in his board area. I watch him on his social media and he's getting things done. And again, I think he'll benefit from being deputy mayor and then hopefully being mayor in a couple of years' time. It'll help him to progress with the political ladder, so to speak, if he wishes to. So I think he's a very competent young man.
I agree. Thank you. Do I have a second there for Chris Wilcox? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Yes, thank you.
I'd like to second the nomination. I've known Chris since he was elected to the Town Council in 2019, and he struck me as being a very hard-working, capable man, and he came and joined the council, and straight away he was taking part, being very involved, being proactive, because that's one of the main things you need from a councillor, is to be proactive and working for their residents, and he puts his residents first at all times, and I think he's a tremendous councillor, and he will make a great deputy mayor, and following on from that, a superb mayor, and well done, Chris.
Thank you very much, Rachel. Thank you, Chris. Can we move to the vote, then, please? Those in favour of the council, Chris Wilcox. That's unanimous as well. Thank you. Congratulations, Councillor Wilcox. And now adjourn the meeting, I believe. And we do a little bit of sort of thing. Right.
Yeah.
Would you like to carry on?
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
That was very nice, wasn't it? Okay, yes, sure.
Hope you'll be able to make it tonight.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Food and suited tonight, because there'll be a bit more in a minute when they come back
yes,
in.
Yes, I gather. Yes,
we only
well, all our family, including Barbara and I, and Dick, and some all good speakers. Once you get them off the seats,
yeah.
Go away.
Yeah. Yes.
Actually, I'm still over here every day, very early days when I look after yourself and what you're doing, you know. You always used to report back and give you information that you didn't know was available.
Stand up, speak up and shut up.
It's quite a nice room for it as well, I think, in
it
here.
Is,
quite
yeah.
airy.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Big,
it's
the big doors
right.
open, yeah.
It's more attractive, I was just telling you. We used to go dancing in the Aston Hall at Lancaster, a very traditional building, and their council chairs really intimidated. On different levels of lack of course.
Yeah.
It's more friendly and open here, isn't it?
Yeah, it is cool. The assembly room upstairs is a bit more formal.
Yeah. You do have that kind of room here, do you? Where there's a one a day,
oh yeah, well
yeah,
there's
yeah.
upstairs there's the assembly room which they used to use in the old days for dancers,
I
think. And there's the what they call the council
chamber,
where Macclesfield Borough Council used to meet.
Yeah.
We still do have some
yeah,
business
yeah,
in
yeah,
there, but
yeah, yeah.
The Cheshire East meetings, we generally meet in this room.
Yeah.
Well, it's convenient, isn't it?
Yeah.
Not going up and down in lifts.
No, there is a
lift right at Cheshire.
Or there has to be. They couldn't make a non-accessible town hall.
Yes, a year as deputy mayor has passed ever so quickly, hasn't it? Yes,
a year ago when we did this, the equivalent of this, it doesn't seem like a year ago.
Yeah. She's had some very interesting visits though, hasn't she? I know she went to see the Caribbean ladies who saw.
Yeah,
you know,
that was one of the better ones. Yeah.
Like that, the big blue and gorgeous groups.
Yeah.
She's had such a fascinating little groups, you know, working away, improving community.
Oh,
and yes.
There'll be more coming up this year, I think. There'd be more
people
getting back
able
to
get
proper,
out
proper
a bit
events.
More,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
I mean, I felt very
I better take a seat again.
My consort, Brian Puddicombe, with his train of office. his consort, Kate Wilcock, with her medal. Looking forward to this, Katie. To Ruth Healy of Legacy Funeral Care for the limo. I think it's the first and only time I've ever been in one in my life. Thank you to all at the Packhorse Social and Bowling Club for making me so welcome in the club. I used to frequent a bar in Spain that had a notice above the front door that says, come here as a customer, leave as a friend. And that is oh so true of the Packhorse. Thank you to Peter Hook for coming over to Macclesfield to publicise the Ian Curtis mural. He spent hours posing for selfies and signing autographs. One American couple, Debbie and Lane from Baton Rouge, contacted me about the stunning mural. Peter and I sat in the courtyard of a little bar here, Proper Sound, and recorded a short message for them. They were absolutely blown away. I estimate very roughly that with social media, TV, magazines, etc., the name of Macclesfield was on the lips of perhaps 2 million people. Peter performed with his band, The Light, at Christchurch recently to a sold-out audience, thanks largely to the organiser, Josie Losey. I think her name's Joe Lowe or something like that. Local stars, Ali and Danny from the Virgin Marys were also on the bill. Again, they gave everything, proudly proclaiming their Macclesfield heritage. Thank you to Emma and Andy Cleek for organising the Macclesfield Festival last summer, a massive success for the town again. Thank you to Matt O'Brien, whose infectious enthusiasm made the rugby fields actually happen. Without him, we simply would not have this stunning facility which hundreds of children enjoy week in, week out. Thank you to the bosses, this is a strange one. Thank you to the bosses of Red Row, Orbit, Emerson and P. Jones for finally getting together and building the footpath stroke cycleway linking Manchester Road and the Middlewood Way. Thank you to the volunteers who ran my two chosen charities, the Windy Way and Macclesfield Roundtable, especially James Hogburn and Christine Earls. The final figure of money raised isn't in yet, but I fully expect it to top 10 grand. Absolutely incredible. Our very own TV star from Flog It, Adam Partridge, did a great job at the charity auction, which raised in one evening £1,960. Thank you to all the schools, colleges, businesses, churches, choirs, theatre groups and orchestras that invited me to meet them. I had a bit of a count up, about 150 visits in the year. Please note that I didn't call them gigs tonight. thank you for inviting me to plant trees all over the place for the Queen's Platinum Jubilee. Thank you to our performers in the year, Tom Blackwell for reciting the Wilfred Owen poem, so movingly at the Cenotaph. Tina Spires for singing at the Church of Light, the Tree of Light, sorry, and Kerry. Mary Woods for her performance at the Titherington Family Worship Church. Talking of the Titherington Family Worship Church and the Thanksgiving Service and Civic Awards, what a great day it was. Thank you to the church, Pastor Steve Parsons. For anyone who wasn't there, Steve was actually persuaded to sing for us. Alex, my cadet, who kept me in line over the year, and everyone involved in helping and organising the service. I'm getting near the end, I promise. Thank yous, I think, probably. Thank you to our officers and rangers. They do an incredible job with limited resources. There is a vibe around the town that started in 2019, and you hopefully now feel it too. Macclesfield is no longer a drab old mill town. It is a fun place to live and work. Laura, Abby, Elena, Andy, and previously Harriet and Jill, thank you. And finally, thank you to my fellow councillors. I simply could not have done half of the things I have done without them. People always look at national politics, or, dare I say it, Hanforth Parish Council. Imagine that it's like that in Macclesfield. Recently, I was asked who the leader of our council was. I actually asked around, and amongst the other councillors. It is something that we had never even discussed. The general consensus was that it must be Fiona Wilson, our new mayor, as she says the most. Forgive me, Madam Mayor. We are simply 12 Macclesfield folk put our heart and soul into our beloved town. And finally, thanks to the residents of Titherington and my wonderful wife Natalia and my family for putting up with my absences over the last year. This has been the proudest year of my life. I wish the incoming Mayor, Councillor Fiona Wilson, and Deputy Mayor, Councillor Chris Wilcock, every possible success in the year of office. Thank you.
second? Finally, I'm very pleased that my parents, Barbara and Mum Wilson, are here this evening to see me become mayor. We are a close and supportive family, and I owe my community values to the example they have shown to me that we are always stronger together. Thank you, Mum and Dad. Thank you, everybody. Internal auditor. So, Town Clerk,
I am consulting with Child Crimes to get that.
Okay, are there any questions or comments on agenda item 13? No? Okay, all those in favour, please show. That's unanimous. Agenda item 14, external support services. This agenda item is for us to approve the reappointment of our various external support services, warehouse employer services for HR and health and safety, Shire's pay services for payroll services, Blaine, Boland and Co solicitors for their legal support, and John Greenhorn Co for finance and accountancy support. Town Clerk, do you wish to make any comment on this?
No, they're all the same as last year, but they've all been, you know, got a good relationship with them and want to carry on working with them. But at some point we probably will have to do a quick recce of what's around, but yes.
In view of them being different providers, I'm going to take the vote separately. But does anybody want to comment on?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. Is it Madam Mayor or Mr. Mayor?
Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Yes, just a comment really on all these four providers. I think that over the last year particularly, I think they have given us great support, because as we are developing, we're more proactive. It's leading to more projects and more involved items that we are taking on, and I think that their support has been outstanding. I really do, and they have given us a lot of help and actually assurance that what we are doing is correct and we're going in the right direction on all the different aspects of work. So obviously we will at some point possibly have to put these out to tender again, but for the moment they've been excellent and I certainly support the action to carry on with them.
Okay, thank you, Councillor Jackson. Anybody else wish to speak on this agenda item? No? Okay, so I'll put the approval one by one then. First of all, for the Wirehouse Employer Services, all those in favour please show. Oh, that's unanimous. To approve Shire's pay services. All those in favour? That's unanimous again. All those in favour to approve Blaine Boland and Co solicitors. All those in favour? Okay. Is that unanimous? Yes. Yeah, thank you, Councillor Howard. And to approve John Greenhall and Co for finance and accountancy support. All those in favour? Thank you very much. So moving to agenda item 15, the Cheshire Association of Local Councils. The action here is for us to consider renewal of our membership of CHALC. The cost for this is £1,470. Of course, CHALC have given us great deal of support, and indeed the very famous Jackie Weaver is their chief executive. Does anybody wish to speak on this agenda item?
Yeah, just to echo what you've just said, Madam Mayor, that they do give us an awful lot of support. They provide training for new councillors. They provide training for new chairs of councils, i.e. mayors. So Jackie Weaver, as I said before, she does know standing, does, because she's teaches them. So yeah, they do a good job and they're really helpful with a lot of different matters.
Okay, thank you. So I'll put that to the vote. All in favour of renewing our membership for CHALC at a cost of £1,470. Unanimous. We also need to consider another membership of the National Allotment Society. This is a cost of £66. I think we've joined the National Allotment Society rather more recently. Does anybody wish to comment on this? Councillor Warren? No? Okay, that leads to the vote. All those in favour? That's agreed unanimously. Okay, so now we come to agenda item 17, the annual report. So we've all had printed copies of the annual report this evening. Does anybody wish to comment on the annual report? Yes, Councillor Bennyway.
Hey, just to say thank you to the officers who produced this, I guess it's Abby, for making a really slick, informative document of everything that we've done this year in a
an accessible way to read with illustrations and photographs and so on. I think it, it does give a good summary in an accessible way, which I think is really important for the system of the time. Thank you.
Okay. Anybody else
want to speak?
Yes.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I think I too would like to thank the officers for their fairness and thoroughness in doing things. And that's a great improvement that we can rely on them for that fairness and thoroughness in accessing, to explaining, and to producing the work that goes on around. Maybe I don't know so much around the town, you can see, but in where I serve, I am very grateful. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I think one of the main things that I like about this, there's so much of all the fantastic projects that the town council has covered over the year, and it's great to just show the successes that we're having and the other projects that will be coming through. But one of the main things, of course, is always, isn't it, well, what do you spend our money on? And quite often it can be a criticism. But when you see the final page of this report, where it's laid out what that precept is spent on and how it actually equates to an amount per week, you know, or whatever, you know, it's a really minimal amount that we're just not even buying to the profit, but we're getting all these different services from the town council. I think it's a really great visual way for people to understand where the town precept goes to and how, what a big bang for the buck they get. You know, they get a tremendous amount for that relatively small amount of money. No money's tight for everyone, but I do think they get really good value for money.
Excuse me, we just have one couple. My wife wants to see what they're doing.
Again, I'd just like to thank the staff who've been involved in the production of the sculptures. I've been on council for 2 years, and it's when I first came here, it at first it was difficult. Again, I'd like to echo the fact that on page 87 and 88, particularly of this, on the original documents, it's listed the priorities for the year. And you'll notice on here that there's some big projects that we're going to make a lot of noise in Macclesfield over the next couple of years, such as the building of the South Park Pavilion. Improvement in signage around the town. Those things are going to be visual and permanent. There's also a lot of things going on in terms of supporting the people who do so much work, the charity and the local community. But yeah, it's probably the big projects that we see with Mural down there, which is, I know we weren't directly, we were there promoting that, weren't we? But those big projects are the ones that kind of excite people, whereas some of the small projects with the smaller grants are really the essential things for all the people who really do a lot of hard work in the town, and we seem to support them. And yeah, it'd be good to see the station gateway at some point on that one, maybe in the future, so that anybody arriving to Macclesfield can walk out of the station and see a thing of beauty in front of them, sort of look out that. But those are all things for the future, so just to thank all the staff and councillors for producing such an excellent and clear document. I've used this on notice boards so that people in Western Ireland can see what the council is doing. It's a great summary, those two pages, and again, for very little money. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Richardson. Anybody else wish to speak on the documents? I mean, I want to add my thanks to our team of staff. They were doing a brilliant job. They're down to three at the moment because we're making some exciting new recruitment initiatives. Our shooting staff will be joining us very soon. But I know in the last few months you've been advising something to the plate to cover even more work, so thank you for that. to make all these events happen. I think that if you look through the Christmas, I mean, there's really good stuff about what Councillor Evans has done as mayor and the community engagement events we've done. All the Christmas events we organised all happened because we planned very sensibly COVID safe events and we delivered on those events. And I think that's really important because we did receive a little bit of criticism about not having a Christmas lights opening ceremony, but we were able to deliver every single event without any change because we properly planned to have those events that were safe for members of the public. And the list of grants and support we were able to give to community organisations. I've seen as first hand as Deputy Mayor the difference that our community organisations make, the volunteers, in delivering for the people of Macclesfield. So this is a great document, I think it's really accessible. And as Councillor Hutchison said, our priorities for 2022-23 are very clear on what we have planned to do. And I think the final page of the document where there's the, I think it's called an infographic, isn't it, where it shows what we're spending our council precept on and how much we are achieving for such a very small increase. I think that I feel very proud that we've delivered so much in so economical a way. So I'll put the annual report to the vote. All those in favour of voting the annual report, please indicate. And that's unanimous, thank you. So we'll move on to agenda item 18, the Christmas lights. Now these last three agenda items are items that we would normally do at a usual council meeting rather than the AGM, but we're time critical, so we need to deal with those tonight. So agenda item 18, the Christmas lights. We have a written report. Does anybody wish to make any comment?
Yes, thank you, Madam Mayor. As you see from the report, obviously the contract was coming to a close with Light. And so we have to then put this out to a tender. It's part of the process. It's a 3-year contract with a total of £100,000 spread over the 3 years. We advertised it. We have seven proposals came forward, seven different companies. We had a panel made up of some of the councillors and officers. So it was three councillors and three officer members. We looked at all the applications very carefully. We scored them, and this was all done independently. And we then had to fill in a scoring sheet. And we didn't know what the result would be. And there we are, it came out. We all preferred Light. Their application was really so good that they won it. And we also selected the different light panels that would be displayed in the town. And you can see from the photograph at the bottom of the page, that is an example of the lighting that will be on Mill Street. And we also selected a separate one to go on Chestergate. And we looked for the widest panels we could get because we felt that would just make it look more complete going down each of the streets. And we've looked at it to be sort of warm white, that sort of thing, rather than all, you know, lots of colour, because I think it's just a bit more classic and it's more masculine. That's what we are, you know, and it looks good. And we can have all the colour with the signs in the shops, and the shops can have the colour, but we'll just put those nice white, warm white lights there to say, you know what, folks, it's Christmas.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Councillor Jackson. Does anybody else wish to speak on this agenda item? Yes, Councillor Harewood.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. While I see towns celebrating so well, I long to see the day when the estates will join the town in this lighting, because when we can link something, even one thing, I'm looking forward to the day when the budget will allow moment, we will do it anyway, but we lack some money.
Thank you. Okay, thank you very much, Councillor Howard. So, anybody else wish to speak on this agenda item? No? Okay, so all those in favour of approving light as our Christmas lights supply for the next 3 years? That's unanimous, thank you. So, agenda item 19, the South Park Pavilion. I'll take the two items separately. First of all, 19.1, the South Park Pavilion equipment of architect. Councillor Livingston.
Thank you very much, Madam Mayor. A pavilion, neatly summarised in my report, an opportunity to provide a facility for the whole of the town. A tens of cafe, communal facilities, accessible toilets, allow potentially to run some events from it. It is part of our ambition to improve the amenity across the town for our residents and to bring more people into our town. And links, they have proposed an ambition to be developed. The pavilion links the master plan. It's been run by Cheshire East Council, increased biodiversity and facilities in the park as well. So I think one of the things that definitely the proud of is the accessible toilets. So part of the work that the town council has done over the last year, amongst many other things to put in the annual report. What we have is I chair the South Park working group. We've had a selection competition for the architects. We had 17 expressions of interest in tenders received from lots of local practices, but some wider, those from the wider national sphere. I think truly it was a difficult choice. Under that said, the quality of submissions was high, the quality of architecture, the potential opportunity for us as the town council was also high. I think with my fellow councillors, we managed to select and agree on an architect, which is a local practice, and I think will provide us the advice, the guidance we need to produce the best building possible on behalf of the town now and to the future. So we have identified our Martin, a local practice, as a preferred architect.
Okay, thank you, Councillor Livingston. Councillor Jackson.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Yes, this is a really exciting project for the people of Macclesfield who have been going to the park and seeing that awful run-down pavilion, lack of facilities. And we know from asking questions of the people that go there that that's one of the things they really want. They want that pavilion to be up and running and providing all the facilities for the users of the park. And just to say that, you know, the little working party that we had was, as Councillor Livingston said, was made up of councillors, but the Spark, who are the South Park, Friends of South Park group, ANSA and CVS, there's a number of other people on that. And again, we had a blind looking at it. Obviously, the councillors knew who the different architects were, but for the people, the non-councillor people, they were given the documents as a blind exercise, so they didn't know who the different architects were, and they had to score them, and at the end, they all scored and came out with Joe Mattin, Alan Mattins, as top. So, and we all independently, all the councillors on the group, scoring independently, found at the end it was Joe Mattin, Alan Mattins, who won the contract. So it was just fantastic. And I do feel that Joe Mattin has done a lot of work locally. He's well known around Macclesfield, and I feel that he will be what I would call a safe pair of hands for the town council. He's already been giving us some advice and some guidance and steering, so I think we can work with him to really bring off a fantastic project and a building that would be a real credit to the town and for the people in Macclesfield.
Okay, thank you, Councillor Jackson. Anybody else wish to speak on this? No? Okay, well, I'll take Councillor Livingston and Councillor Jackson as a mover and seconder of of the action to approve Bo Mattin as the chosen architect for South Park Pavilion. All those in favour, please show. That's unanimous, thank you. Okay, agenda item 19.2. This is the budgeting exercise where we allocate £100,000 for parks and play areas. And there is a recommendation here from the Services Committee. The Services Committee is recommending to full council that the budgeted amount of £100,000 for parks goes this year towards South Park Pavilion. We've just been talking about it. This will pay for the architect, the surveys and the structural engineers. Does anybody wish to speak on this issue? Councillor Jackson.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Well, I would like to propose this. And the reason being that the Town Council have had this budgeted amount, a regular amount every year, to support the different wards around the town for their play areas. And this has been going on since the Town Council was created, so we're now in the second term now. And I was elected at the very beginning of the Town Council. And so I've seen each year how ward by ward the play areas have had money spent on them, and every ward has had its share, shall we say, of the money. And we're now at this point really coming round to begin that circle again. And it was proposed that at this point it would be a good idea to use this 100,000 to put it towards the project for the South Park Pavilion and identify as this part of phase one what that money would be spent on. So it wouldn't just go into a big pot and we wouldn't really know where it had gone. It's specific, it's been specified for that part of phase one. And I think that it's an excellent way to use that money and show to residents of Macclesfield this is what we're going to do with that money, rather than just looking for a play area. It's so-and-so's turn, let's go and find a play area to spend this money. I think we've got a great project there, we should focus on that and give it to that. So I'm quite happy to nominate this.
Okay, thank you, Councillor Jackson. Councillor Law.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I'd just like to speak in support of the proposal that Councillor Jackson has made in relation to the Parks and Players budget. As has been mentioned, each ward within the town has already had a proportion of money spent on the parks and play areas. As we are fully aware, this year marks the 200th year of the park, South Park. I do apologise. We were hopefully given the position of having a new pavilion, so I think it says to the people of Macclesfield that we've got the money ready to spend, we're going to start it and get the course set in place straight away.
Okay, so thank you. So the recommendation from the Services Committee has been moved and seconded here. Does anybody else wish to speak on the recommendation? Yes, Councillor
Hutchison. I think that the whole South Pavilion area is very exciting. I talked before about big projects. On this occasion, we're talking about £100,000 going towards it, which I think I would be in favour of as a one-off. I think getting away from having that allocation of money from the wards, still would like to continue to do that because there was a facility for children, and I don't know if there's enough facilities for youth within the town. And so, but as a one-off, I think it's a very good use of the money too, because it's going to be a massive project, and then the big mall of Macclesfield are going to be going up have to use those facilities. And I think having a big exciting project like this would be really good idea.
Councillor Livingstone.
Yeah, thanks. Listen to my fellow councillors, and I thank them for supporting this. This is clearly ambitious. I can give you assurance with the working group. We'll steward the money very carefully. We'll try and drive the best deal on behalf of the town in terms of facilities that we can provide. But I do appreciate the support.
I mean, there is precedent for giving the full amount in 1 year to a particular play area, which we did with the Wimble Street Park, and so it isn't an unusual thing for us to do. I'm just going to very briefly say, you all know how much I love South Park and how much time I spend in it, and I'm asked every week at Park when where's the building coming, and you know, the provision recently of the free bars went to the toilets building.
I'm just going to say, I don't know if Councillor Edwards got
those other Cheshire councillors who aren't members of this council. But I'm quite happy to feed back into all members on what happens at that meeting. I think I know what's going to happen. I'd just like to feed it in, and that will feed our response to the consultation. That's okay.
Okay, thank you. Councillor Howard.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. As far as I've been informed, a number of parishes have been consulted, those who have complained. Macclesfield is not the only one, because a number of councils said how difficult it was for them last winter. And that matter is being pursued in case of, I'm heartened that consultations can be overturned. And if it doesn't come back, I will be one councillor who will be trying to return something that goes against our health and well-being. I really, really will. So I hope something good comes out of it, because the contract that Cheshire has is for Lindley Jacobs to have this overall thing that they don't feel they can challenge. But maybe there is some give there. Maybe there is some give there. But I still hope that within that governance committee, when we are not satisfied, we will continue to challenge that. And I think that's the right thing to do.
Anybody else want to speak? Yes, Mike. Oh, sorry, councillor.
Yeah, just in the presence of Cheshire East councillors here, what I'm very interested to know, because we were having these discussions in November, I think, about Britain, and subsequently the winter was relatively mild. So what I'm really interested in, because this is no proposal, because they're not doing the review, they're not giving an opportunity to get street parking, and they're just but now suddenly they're not happy for us to pay for it. They weren't happy for us to pay for it before. They're willing to pay for it, and then there'll be something to pay for it. It seems to be really, really confused. So I'm not happy with the process. But I think that you've got a situation here where they must have saved a lot of money over the winter, because those grids have not been out. So I want to know what happens to that money that they've saved. Is it being spent for grids? If so, then we should be quids in. Should be able to get those roads back in. So I just ask any councillors here that should be going to those Cheshire East meetings, find out please how much was spent on Britain in terms of the overall budget, and how much was saved because of the mild weather, and do we really need to take these roads back out?
Councillor
Howard. I'm sorry to come back on this, Madam Mayor. What I want to know is who made the decision to withdraw from the road? Who did? Did we make a decision? Well, we asked before, and I think we ought to have been asked. And on that, I will challenge them again, because when our health is jeopardized, ain't going to work for me.
My understanding is that when the Cheshire East Council Highways undertook the winter gritting review in line with the well-managed highways recommendations from central government, there were some streets that were removed from the gritting schedule in Macclesfield. We as a town council expressed our serious concerns about that, and we then tried to pay to reinstate the gritting on the four steepest roads in Macclesfield, because councillors for those boards, Worley Road, Lakelow Road, Windmill Street and Buncombe Lane, were very concerned about the safety of their residents, particularly in some areas of Macclesfield, visiting health staff who were visiting individuals at home to provide health care. We at that stage allocated £12,000 at our full council to pay for those roads to be budgeted by our own provider, but that was refused by Cheshire East Highways. So the original review was by Cheshire East Highways. Our full council wanted to pay for the gritting of those roads. Cheshire East Council Highways, to sum it up, wouldn't take our money because they hadn't any policy on the issue. Now it seems, from my point of view, as a Southwold council, they are prepared to take our money even though the policy hasn't changed. Myself and the
Park attended a meeting on the 23rd of December where it was actually snowing, although we were on a Zoom meeting, so we were inside. Certainly my view, and I expressed this at the Finance Committee, is that we should be campaigning to have these streets reinstated. The streets I've just gone through are in South Ward and East Ward are extremely steep streets. So the issue we have here, I feel, is that our next meeting doesn't permit us to make a second decision. Yet if we make the decision tonight, we'll pay for it. We're never going to get those roads back in the gutting schedule. So my personal preference, particularly with the Cheshire East councillors here who are also town councillors, that we do go back, and there are other Cheshire East councillors in the room as well who are not town council members, that we go back and we say that we want those put back in the schedule and make those arguments. And then I think if that ends up not being around, we have to find a way of reconvening ourselves to deal with the issue. One possibility would be for you to agree that the chair or the vice chair of the Finance Committee, along with the town clerk, would make that decision. Because at the moment, the paperwork we have here says that the budget is likely to be £3,622, which is quite interesting, bearing in mind that compared to what Brian would probably be. I think Councillor Boyle was correct. The amount that's been stipulated by Cheshire East Highways now is really sort of a third of what a private provider would be. So I think if we take a decision now to agree we'll do this, we've sold the pass to put in the vernacular. So that's my thoughts on the matter, whether anyone wants to pick up those issues, that we maintain our position of wanting those roads back in the schedule. We wait to hear what the outcome of that is. We can hear already that our Cheshire East colleagues are campaigning on that issue. They have our backing to discuss this a number of times. And then if it comes to, if there are roads left out of the schedule, we look at those roads and we consider what the cost would be. And if the cost is below £10,000, of course, it could be dealt with by the Finance Committee. Or in fact, if it was below £3,000, it could be dealt with by the town clerk. So that is my suggestion to you as the way forward. So we keep our powder dry and don't agree we'll pay anyway if they say no, because I think that is only going to end up with us paying anyway. Views, councillors. Yes, Councillor Jackson.
Yeah, can I just say, Madam Mayor, I totally agree with that, Stan, because otherwise any other way of going about it would then just lead Cheshire East to the, well, we don't need to put them in the programme because the town council will pick the money, pick it up and pay it. And that isn't the case as far as I'm concerned anyway. We, you know, yes, we want our residents to be safe, but we have to look at what we spend our money on. And it's Cheshire East's responsibility to look after the highways. We have other responsibilities for our residents. And we shouldn't have to be picking up Cheshire East responsibilities. And that's it as far as my view. You know, that's my view. So I will support what has been suggested by yourself, Matthew.
Anybody else wish to comment? Yes, Councillor.
I'd like to support it as well. You know, we do have clear demarcation of things from the town council doing the Cheshire East, and even on my short time on the council. One or two things which are slipping over that we need to modify, hardly, because our house is getting longer, maybe theirs are going shorter. So we need to be aware of that. You know, we have a limited funds, and we're looking to, you know, make the town, really, you see, everyone's seen the list of things we're trying to do. We're getting more staff, we're getting more ambitious, and we want to be able to spend that money on the town and on things that traditionally have been paid for by a bigger council. Cheshire East Highways, and there is all the fact that it's national government that we're underfunding now. So it's slipping through, that national underfunding is slipping through to Cheshire East, and therefore onto the highways, and now tumbling down to us. So you know, we perhaps need to publicise that at some time. yeah, it's the only way we can do it. We can't do anything else, I don't think.
Okay, anybody else wish to speak on this? Right. No, so on 10.2 we are going to go back and tell you all the streets that
were removed from the schedule to be returned to the schedule, and our Cheshire East Councillor colleagues and town councillors will campaign appropriately with Cheshire East Highways. We will then, when we get that response, consider our response to 20.1. Depending on the outcome, we will find an appropriate, financially sound way of agreeing the budget depending on the amount, which will likely involve a referral to the Finance Committee or the Chair and Vice Chair of the Finance Committee or the Town Clerk, depending on the amount. Are we all, I've summarised what we think.
Can I just say though that in my view there is no guarantee that Town Council will pay for top up rating. I think we have to make that clear, because if we don't make it clear, doesn't matter what we say, Cheshire East will just not include them in the programme. So I think we have to be quite, you know, quite strong with it to say we may consider some top up scheme, but we could just as easily not. And I think we have to make that clear, Madam Mayor.
Absolutely, completely agree. What I'm trying to do really is find us a way forward if we are in that situation that meets our government requirements.
Yes.
But my view is that we should not pay. The road should be reinstated.
Yeah.
But I think you've all heard me say that quite a few times. I'm talking too much now. Okay, all those in favour, please. Anybody against?
I'm not against, by the way, but I agree with Councillor Jackson. I have abstained because it is Cheshire East's responsibility. We are not responsible for highways, and I don't think we should let them in that sort of view. They will have to do it or tell us why. So I have abstained.
Okay, thanks very much indeed. Agenda item 20.3, the Highway Survey of Town and Parish Satisfaction. We also had a discussion about this at the Finance Commission. I think now we're basically summarised that we are dissatisfied with Cheshire East Highways. We had a discussion about pothole repair and all those sorts of issues. I think it's possibly wise, looking at the survey form, that members complete those themselves, because although it's called the Highway Survey of Town and Parish Satisfaction, it's very clearly aimed at individual councillors. So does anybody wish to speak on this? Yes, Councillor Livingstone.
I think Councillor have just covered the issues I think we face. We should follow them. I encourage all my councillors to follow them. Councillors to complete it. We do recognise the withdrawal of all government funding in terms of the roads. We also recognise the previous Cheshire East administration came up with a 15-year contract with the region. The likes of which have been constructed for 30 years now that I've seen. So you need to actually ask a contractor to give them all the money, all the staff, and then monitor their own work.
Yes.
But I'm delighted to see that Cheshire East are bringing in monitoring, which will hopefully improve the staff and the students. But we'll see them, which is a temporary thing for the challenge. And we'll push to see improvements in the project.
Thank you.
and that was on Chilton Avenue, if you want to know exactly where it was. So if you go down Chilton Avenue, you might actually understand why they're making comments on the state of the road. It's absolutely shocking. But if we could get everybody to make a comment on that, then perhaps we'd get some improvement.
Perhaps deliver a few of the surveys to residents on Chilton Avenue.
Certainly to slow down traffic, because you've got to go very slowly over some of those big holes in the road. It's not great.
Okay, so on 20.3 then, we will share the survey on our social media, so councillors can also share it, and if necessary, we can get some printed copies for people who request them. Okay, all those in favour of that course of action? Anybody against? Any abstentions? Okay, thank you, that's agreed. So, we've reached the end of the meeting. The date, time and place of the next meeting will be 7 p.m. on the 13th of June at Oxmill Town Hall. Thank you very much everyone for attending this evening, to the members of the public.